In this episode, I want to talk a little bit about supering colonies. So here is a medium super. Here is a hive that I need to put the super onto. And I want to tell you some of the tricks that I've used to know that it's time to add a super. But before I start with that, I want to tell you why people add supers in the first place. Well, supers are generally added to hives by beekeepers for one principal reason, and that's to take advantage of the incoming nectar and provide a place for the bees to make honey, right? We add supers almost exclusively for the purpose of producing honey. We're giving the bees more space to store that nectar, to dehydrate it, to make it into honey, to cap it over so that we can harvest and have it for sale later. But because nectar flows are often timed with swarm season, right? Bees want to swarm and there's copious amounts of nectar coming in. Adding supers also gives bees more space to expand and will slightly reduce that nest congestion in the hive that can lead the bees to swarm. So it's kind of a dual purpose. So we put it on for honey production purposes, but we get the added benefit of a little bit of swarm mitigation. So when do you know to add your super to your hive? Well, there's four things that I use to make that decision. First, I like to have a general knowledge of the typical nectar flow in the region. For example, if I know that my major nectar flow begins somewhere around April 15th, I might add a super around the 1st of April or the 7th of April to have it in place for that anticipated nectar flow. I might also, in my second case, start noticing increased activity at the nest entrance, and specifically activity where the bees are coming and going, but they're not all bringing pollen, right? Bees will leave this nest for really one of four main reasons: to collect nectar, to collect pollen, to collect water, or to collect tree saps or plant rosins. Well, if they're coming back to the hive without tree sap on their legs, and they're coming back to the hive without pollen on their legs, and I make that next assumption that they're bringing in copious amounts of nectar. So I'm trying to match that activity with plants that I know are blooming that the bees like to use. The third thing that will tell me that I need to begin thinking about adding supers is when I remove the lid from this hive, the uppermost box is starting to have white wax and nectar's being stored in it. You see, even when you add a super of foundation or a super of pulled comb, when there's incoming nectar, bees are going to convert some of that energy to wax to pull out that comb further to make burr comb. So white wax in the nest is a really good indication that there's incoming resources and the bees are converting that nectar to wax. The fourth indication to me that it's time to add a super is when I'm working a hive and pull a frame and turn it sideways. If I jiggle it or shake it just lightly, unripe nectar will rain from the comb. So if I'm working this hive and I pull a frame that looks like it has a lot of uncapped nectar, I'll turn that frame sideways, shake it just a little, and if it rains out, then that's further confirmation to me that bees are bringing in nectar and storing it in the comb. So again, a good knowledge of the area nectar flow when it starts, increased activity at the nest entrance, white comb and nectar being put in it when looked at from above, and fourth and finally, nectar raining on me almost as I work through the nest. So with all of those indications in place, then I'd want to bring a super to the apiary and put it on my hive, which leads to this discussion. Where do I put the super? Well, there's been this age-old debate whether one top supers or bottom supers, and what's the difference? Well, this hive will help me teach that concept. It already has a super on it. This particular super is full of honey that they consume. We never take this super off. It's always for the bees. But some of the logic for supering goes like this. If I'm a beekeeper and bottom super, which means put the empty super below the existing honey super, then the bees have more direct access to it and maybe they'll fill it quicker. So I put that below the full super, get their attention earlier. Top super advocates would simply remove the lid and put the super on top and say that it makes no difference. I might as well save myself the trouble of removing this one before putting on another one. There's one research project of which I'm aware, and it showed it really didn't matter, so you might as well top super to save your back. So let's pretend, for example, that all four of those criteria were met 2 weeks ago, which caused me to put this super on. So how will I know to add this second super? Again, those four criteria still need to exist. I need to know that the honey flow is ongoing. I still need to see increased activity at the nest entrance. I need to see the bees are putting honey and pulling wax here. And nectar needs to flow on me sort of when I'm working this hive. But I'll know it's time to add a super when I remove the lid from the hive and when I look from above and see that, you know, 80% or more of the combs are covered with bees. And I'm looking directly down on above and I see that. So in this case, I know I can take this super. This super happens to be one of just frames of foundation. I put it right on top like so. And I add the lid and it really is as simple as that. Now, there is a really important thing to consider. It is conceivably possible to add this super when it's not necessary, right? Maybe I'm not going up in the nectar flow. Maybe the nectar flow is crested and is starting to go down. So rather than adding more space, I would really want them to concentrate on filling and ripening the nectar in the cells that's here in this super. So if I'm in the last third or the last quarter of the nectar flow, maybe I wouldn't add this super. But if I'm in the first two-thirds or the first three-quarters of the nectar flow, I would add this super and then make the decision next time I work this hive whether to remove this super if the bees aren't using the combs, if they're not feeling them. I might remove the super so they can concentrate their remaining efforts here. It's really simple. Timing the bloom, recognizing the activity, seeing the nectar being stored, and noticing that there's plenty of unripe nectar in those cells, seeing a really good population of bees in the super that I already added, all of those are indicators to me that it's time to put on that next super.